All right, everyone, and welcome to the final movie review of the Star Wars saga, as we will be finally covering Star Wars, The Force Awakens, Episode 7, The Grand Return, directed by J.J. Abrams. And initially, love this movie. Really, really like this movie. I liked it when I first saw it, and I like it now that I've seen it multiple times. I have both positives and negatives for it, and we're going to get into that right away. First, the positives. Number one, love J.J. Abrams directing. Did a fantastic job. Abrams directed the first two of the Star Trek movies in the new continuity. Thought he did a good job with those, and he brought that same passion and fire to the new Star Wars. You can tell by watching the Star Wars movie that he has a profound respect and love for the material and the characters, and it really shows on screen. I love the usage of location shooting. It's refreshing to finally see real places instead of CGI landscapes and green screen. I love the mixture of practical and CGI effects. It makes the film to me look more realistic and more epic and grand in a way. Of course, Johnny Williams' score is amazing because it's fucking Johnny Williams and he's the fucking man. So that's also fantastic. I love the return of the old cast. I love seeing Han and Chewie again. Their chemistry is still fun to watch. C-3PO and R2-D2 are back, and it's always fun to see those two. They don't have a lot to do, but just seeing them is pretty cool. Seeing Leia again is pretty cool. Now she's like General Organa, like the leader of the Resistance, so that's pretty cool. I really, really like the characters of Poe and Finn. Poe Dameron is pretty much like your new generation Han Solo. But where Han Solo is a smuggler, Poe Dameron is an X-Wing fighter. And he's touted as being the best X-Wing fighter in the Resistance. And in the couple of scenes, you see him, you know, behind an X-Wing or a TIE fighter. He really is one of the best. He can get himself out of any jam, and he's a natural leader. And it shows in the scenes that you see him in when he's leading a battle, and he comes across as very likable too. Like Oscar Isaacs just comes across as just a very likable guy, as Poe Dameron. And I hope to see more, and I want to see more of that. I can't wait to see more of that in Episode 8. The character of Finn is a former stormtrooper, and on his first mission, he sees horrors, and he sees what the First Order is doing to this defenseless village, and he's just simply horrified by it, and he can't bring himself to be part of something like this, so he rebels against them and joins the Resistance and befriends Poe Dameron, and their budding friendship kind of reminds me a little bit of Luke Skywalker and Han Solo, and I can't wait to see how those two progress in their friendship. Another relationship that I really, really liked is the relationship between Han Solo and Finn, because it kind of reminds me of Luke and Obi-Wan's relationship from the original trilogy. Only this is done on a more, I guess you could say, more grounded level, where it's pretty much, you know, Han Solo, the smuggler, you know, the rogue, the badass, and Finn, this budding good guy. And seeing those two banter off one another is pretty funny. I love the scene where Finn calls Solo, and Solo's like, "Did you just call me Solo?" And Finn's like, "Han, or is that Solo?" I thought that was pretty funny. And I love the scene where Finn reveals to Han that he's only here to save Rey, and he says, "The Force could help us." And Han says, "That's not how the Force works." I thought that shit was hilarious. So yeah, Finn and Han to me have really, really good, you know, chemistry going on there. And unfortunately, knowing what we know from this movie, we're not going to see that develop. But for what I did see, loved it. Thought it was really well, really, really, really well handled. I also, I can get behind the whole thing with Rey and Finn and their friendship, and I'm pretty interested to see where that could go in the future films. So I got no problem with that. I liked the character of Kylo Ren from the beginning, and near the end, I was starting to like feel sorry. And at, near the end, I was starting to like, you know, turn on him a little bit. But hopefully, they can fix that up. Of course, when you first see Kylo Ren, he's just this monster badass. He fucking pretty much gives an order to kill the entire village. He almost kills Poe trying to get information out of him. And he just comes across as this unstoppable force. But then, you know, pretty much very early on in the movie, before we even reach the 1 hour mark of this movie, it's revealed that he is the son of Han and Leia. And it's not a problem for me. I just wish they would have saved that near to the end of the movie, especially that the bridge scene that he has with Han and the overall result of that bridge scene where he kills Han. I thought right before he kills Han is where we get the revelation that he is the son of Han. I thought that would have played better for the drama. But again, it doesn't affect the movie. It's just, to me, bad placement. But I'm on enough to him being conflicted because, like, I would like it better if he didn't come across as like a whiny little bitch with daddy issues. I think I would have liked it better if he was like, we get a sense he's conflicted, but I think I would have liked it if it was more of a Darth Vader confliction, where Darth Vader is wrestling with his conflict, but you don't see him like having these soliloquies to himself, with himself, which pretty much spells out that I am conflicted, I am tortured, I don't know if I want to be to the good guy or want to be like my grandfather. Someone, please help me. I thought that shit was like getting a little annoying to me in a way, and I did not like that at all. But the stuff I did like with Kylo, I liked. And I think I can get behind Supreme Leader Snoke. I need to see more. Of course, but you know what I did see was like, okay, I think I can roll with this. He's kind of like our new emperor. Hopefully he's not a carbon copy of the emperor. Now we get to the negatives and the things I did not like about this movie. I'll get to the small things before I get to the big thing, which I think is problematic for this movie and potentially for the rest of the series. Small things first. The character of General Hux kind of is very wasted in this movie. I would have liked to have seen more. Throughout the course of the movie, you see him and Kylo Ren are vying for the attention of Supreme Leader. And you constantly see them trying to one-up each other. I would like to know the origins of this rivalry and how it came about and why they have this, you know, competition going on. Because to me, they just seem like two puppy dogs fighting for the master's attention, and I don't know the backstory behind it. I would like to know more about this. Hopefully they can explain it in Part 8 as to why they have this rivalry going on. But it overall renders Hux kind of useless because he doesn't really have a whole lot of depth to him. I mean, he has a couple of cool scenes here and there where we get that cool scene where it's almost reminiscent of Nazi Germany and he comes across like Hitler, which I thought was pretty interesting. But again, it doesn't really do much when there's no substance to the character. Hopefully they can fix that. Another character that I think was absolutely wasted is Captain Phasma, who is pretty much like this chrome stormtrooper leader. And take this character out of the movie and it's the same movie because she brings nothing to the table. And I think it's a waste of the character, and hopefully they can redeem that in Episode 8. Again, I said what I needed to say about Kylo Ren, things I did like, things I didn't like. And I stand by those, and it's not going to change whatsoever. But when I get to my big problem, I'm gonna elaborate even more on the things I don't like about the Kylo Ren character and what they overall do with it. Which actually brings me to Rey. I don't like the character of Rey whatsoever. I mean, when she was first introduced, I was okay with it. I thought she was okay. I thought she was good. I thought she was being handled pretty well. But she keeps whining and whining and complaining. I have to go back to Jakku. I have to stay on Jakku. The whole thing as to why she wants to stay on this fucking planet is because one day my family will come back. Motherfucker, your family abandoned you. They left you crying in the desert. They ain't coming back for your stupid ass. But she still thinks, my family will come back. They will come back. I hate her. I hate her. She's whining like a little bitch. And she wasn't that annoying. She wasn't like that whiny, the whiny. She wasn't like whiny in the sense where Luke Skywalker was whiny. But Luke Skywalker whininess, I could, you know, I can let go because he was yearning for an adventure and did not want to stay on a planet. He wanted, you know, to go out and fight and do something with his life. Rey is just whining and complaining, and that's all she fucking does is whine and complain about Jakku and her family, and fuck your fucking family already. They left your stupid ass. Do something with your life, bitch. And the madness of this fucking character does not stop there. It keeps progressing, and it gets even worse. Okay, so we get to this. Kylo Ren kidnaps Rey, trying to get the information as to where Luke Skywalker's whereabouts. Before I continue on, the whole crust of the story is Luke has gone missing, and the Resistance and the First Order is trying to find him, but they can't find him because they're missing a piece of the map. And the only person, and BB-8 has the piece to that map, but Rey also saw the piece to that map when BB-8, you know, showed everyone in the Millennium Falcon exactly as the piece of that map as a whole. So Rey has that information in her mind, and Kylo Ren is trying to, you know, get it out of her. So, you know, he's using the Force, the mind meld, trying to extract the information. Then out of fucking nowhere, Rey just mind fucks him. And now I'm thinking, how are you able to mind fuck this guy? You're not a Jedi. And they made no reference to you even being a Jedi. They made no hints of you having Jedi powers. When you went to Maz Kanata's place, you know, you found Luke's, you know, lightsaber, you touched it, but from what I remember, touching a lightsaber doesn't automatically grant you Jedi powers. You gotta be born with it. So she mind fucks him. And I'm just wondering, okay, how the hell are you able to mind fuck this guy? How the hell are you able to resist this guy who is strong with the Force, is trained by the Force, was trained by Luke fucking Skywalker, the most powerful Jedi in the Star Wars universe? How are you able to hold your own in a mind meld with this fucking guy? That's strike one. Strike two. How the fuck are you able to... Let me calm down for a second before I start yelling and screaming like a madman. Let me try and be more constructive. In three... Two, one. How are you able to mind trick a stormtrooper if you have no concept of the Force? Not only that, you openly admitted that you thought the Force was a myth and that Luke Skywalker was a myth. How are you able to control? How are you able to mind trick with no training and no concept? How is that possible? I don't get it. Luke Skywalker trained for 3 movies to develop his powers. This fucking bitch comes in first movie out. She's using her powers like she's been using them for 25,000, like she's been using them for 30 years. How is that possible? I don't get it. And what's even more worse, when we get to the fight scene between Kylo, Finn, and Rey in the snow. Finn, highly trained. He was a stormtrooper. Trained to kill, trained to fight. Holds his own against Kylo Ren, but ultimately gets his ass kicked and almost dies. Then Rey comes in. And this fucking bitch nearly kills Kylo Ren and is able to hold her own against someone who is highly trained, and this bitch has no fucking training whatsoever, is able to almost kill the fucking guy. You've made Rey the John Cena of Star Wars. Rey is supposed to be the hero that throughout the course of the movie is supposed to conquer all, go through all the obstacles, all the hardships, and eventually, you know, come out as the sparkling hero. You pretty much compacted 3 movies into 1 movie with this bitch. Why do I care to want to see her again? You already overpowered her. You made her fucking use the Force like she was using, like she's been using it for all her life. She's able to mind trick on a dime. She's able to use a lightsaber on a dime. against someone who's highly trained and was trained by Luke Skywalker. Not only that, you had Kylo Ren look like a fucking bitch to this bitch who has no training. So the guy who has training fucking gets bitched up by some bitch who has no training. Stupid. Doesn't make any sense to me. Again, Rey is like John Cena. John Cena is the obstacle that Kylo Ren has to overcome. I don't feel sorry for fucking Rey. I feel sorry for Kylo Ren. I want to get behind Kylo Ren because I want Kylo Ren to take down fucking Rey, because Kylo Ren is the guy that has to go through all the obstacles, is the villain that has to go through the obstacles of the good guy, because the good guy is so over fucking powered and can easily take him down. I want Kylo Ren to fucking find that jet, to find that mustard to fucking kill the bitch. You fucking swapped your characters and you don't even realize that you did it. That's lazy, sloppy writing. I don't know why they did that. I would like to know why they did that. I want to know why you fucking overpowered Rey so early on in the franchise. What story is there to tell? Why does she need to find Luke? She doesn't need to fucking find Luke and get trained, because she's acting like she's been trained for 30 years. Stupid. I did not like it whatsoever. I hate Rey. I don't like Rey. I know Rey has a lot of fans. I ain't one of them. I think she's completely fucking useless now. If anything, I want to see fucking Finn get trained by fucking Luke. Because at least Finn was able to hold his own, but he got his ass kicked. He got his ass kicked. You know, you gave Kylo Ren some shine, but you also gave Finn some shine. But at the same time, you made Finn sympathetic because he almost died. I want to see Finn get trained. Fuck fucking Rey. She don't need to get trained. She needs to fucking leave. So with all that being said, we finally get to the end of the movie. And to me, this makes up for all the garbage that happened with Rey and Kylo Ren. Is when Rey is where we finally get to see Luke. And it's just one of those feel-good moments as a fan seeing Luke Skywalker essentially, you know, potentially take on the mantle of Obi-Wan as that wise old mentor. And just seeing him, it just, you know, brought back so many awesome memories of Star Wars and why I love it so much. And it gave me those chills that I never got in a movie, that I haven't had in a movie in such a long time. And just seeing that, just, you know, made me feel good inside, and I just enjoyed every minute of it. And I can't wait for episode 8 where Luke has a more bigger role, because in this movie Luke does not have a role. He's essential to the plot, but when you finally get to see him, he has no lines of dialogue. It's all just facial expression acting, which I like over dialogue acting. And the emotions and the facial expressions of Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker in this final scene was fantastic, and I loved every minute of it, and I can't wait to see what happens with it. So, that is my look at The Force Awakens. With everything being said, with all my negatives and positives, I still really like this movie, and I'm going to give it a solid 8 out of 10. It is a good return to form. J.J. Abrams did a fantastic job of bringing back the original spirit of Star Wars with this one. I mean, yeah, the skeletal plot is pretty much a New Hope remake, but the external plot, you know, makes it stand on its own, and that to me is more important than the overall skeletal plot. Because let's face it, let's be real, folks. Every single movie that's made pretty much has the same skeletal plot. It's the inside that matters the most, and in my opinion, for better or worse. The meaty stuff, you know, it worked. For the most part, it worked. And that's the biggest compliment I can give this movie for doing. Well, I am AJ Legend. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you again next time.